The third paper in this session is a unified fault matrix method for the calculation of shunt and series faults in power systems with complete duality of shunt and series fault matrices. And it will be presented by Professor Lutz Hoffmann. He is a full professor at and head of the Institute of Electric Power Systems at the Leibniz University in Hanover, Germany. And since 2011, he's also head of subject area transmission networks at the Fraunhofer Institute for Wind Energy and Energy Systems Technology in Kassel, Germany. So Lutz, please, your presentation.
Yeah, thank you very much for your introduction, Mr. Chairman. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm glad to have the opportunity to present the main points and results of my paper on the calculation of shunt and series faults in power systems using the unified fault matrix method and showing the complete duality of shunt and series fault matrices. In power systems, unbalanced operating conditions can occur, for example, due to line-to-earth or line-to-line short circuits, which will be called shunt faults in the following, and single-pole or multi-pole interruptions, which result, for example, due to switching operations, and which will be called series faults. Each fault type is described by specific fault conditions for the three phase voltages and currents at the fault location. Generally, faults can occur as single fault or as multiple faults, which occur simultaneously at different fault locations. The knowledge of fault currents and voltages is essential, for example, for dimensioning of electrical equipment and for protection settings. The necessary calculations of fault currents and voltages using typical simulation approaches can lead either to numerical inaccuracies due to rounding errors if the fault impedances become zero, as well as in case of electrical equipment with isolated neutral, or the uniform 3x3 structure is disturbed by the formation of additional nodes when having ideal interruptions, or the disappearance of nodes when having ideal short circuits. Additionally, the handling of multiple faults can be complex and the number of simultaneous faults may be limited. One method which avoids these mentioned problems is a unified fault matrix method. Using this method, the formulation of fault conditions at the fault location is carried out with the help of 3x3 incidence matrices. By this, a systematic fault description is enabled, the three-phase structure is retained, and ideal faults are simulated without numerical problems. For example, having an ideal one-phase line-to-earth short circuit in conductor A, the fault conditions are: voltage in conductor A is zero, and the fault currents in the faultless conductors B and C are also zero. These fault conditions for the currents and voltages can be formulated separately using a fault matrix F maintaining a three-phase structure. To carry out unbalanced fault calculations, the fault conditions have to be incorporated into the branch equations of electrical equipment and into the nodal grid equation system, respectively. The fault matrix is typical for each fault. Up to now, there is a duality shown between line-to-earth shunt faults and interruptions of electrical equipment with neutral grounding. This can be seen in the table on the right-hand side. The objective of the paper in this presentation is the extension of the unified fault matrix method regarding a complete duality between shunt and series faults. In particular, the duality between line-to-line short circuits and interruptions of equipment with isolated neutral and the corresponding fault matrices is worked out. Series faults have to be incorporated into the branch equation system of electrical equipment. In the figure, a voltage source equivalent circuit of an electrical equipment with neutral earthing is shown. On the left-hand side, the corresponding equation system is given. Delta UZ are the voltages at a possible interruption at the terminals of the electrical equipment, with the fault admittance YF representing the reciprocal of an arc resistance ZF. UME is the neutral point voltage. UQ designates the voltage sources in case of an active equipment like a generator. UZ, IZ, and ZZ are the terminal voltages and currents and the branch impedance matrix. The neutral point voltage and the voltages at the interruption can be expressed by the neutral point impedance and the fault impedances and the branch current. Solving for the terminal voltages yields the equation in admittance form given here. This display type of the branch equation shows exemplarily the problems arising from modeling ideal interruptions at the terminals of electrical equipment with isolated neutral. Having an isolated neutral means setting ZME going to infinity, which is not possible and causes numerical problems. Equally, having an ideal interruption in only one or two conductors leads to the same numerical problems. The same numerical problems also arise in alternative formulations of the branch equation or when using the Woodbury formula for calculating the inverse matrix. This is shown in the paper and will not be discussed here any further. To overcome these problems, the unified fault matrix method offers a solution. On this slide, the modeling of series fault using the unified fault matrix method is shown. In a first step, the three fault conditions at the interruption are formulated. Each interruption can have a fault impedance, modeling, for example, an arc resistance. Here, the reciprocal value, the fault admittance, are used. The fault conditions can be incorporated into the branch equation. This is also shown in the paper and is also described in the mentioned literature. As a result, the inverse impedance matrix, the admittance matrix YZF exists and can be calculated for all series faults with or without neutral earthing. This is possible since the fault conditions for the terminal currents and the voltages at the interruption shown above are incorporated in different rows of the branch equation system. By this, the calculation of the inverse is always ensured. For example, the branch equation of an electrical equipment without neutral earthing can easily be calculated by setting the neutral admittance to zero. The same applies for an ideal interruption by setting the fault admittance to zero. The case having a fault impedance of zeros, which means that there is no interruption, is also prevented since the fault matrix has a row of zeros in the affected row. The resulting branch equation in admittance form is equal in its structure to that of a branch without interruptions and with neutral earthing and can easily be incorporated into the nodal grid equation system for the calculation of the nodal voltages and subsequently of the branch occurrence. This is shown next. A nodal grid equation system can easily be formulated without using topological tools like a tree and meshes, only by using the nodal current equations, the topological rule, and the branch equations of all electrical equipment, which is here shown here on the above slide. The resulting nodal grid equation system consists of the nodal admittance matrix, YKK, the nodal voltage vector, UK, and the nodal current source vector, IK. Shunt faults occur at the network nodes, as illustrated in the figure on the right-hand side. Shunt faults have to be modeled in the nodal grid equation system. Having a shunt fault, the nodal voltages change, and additional nodal fault currents, IF, have to be considered. A fault impedance or fault admittance, modeling, for example, an arc resistance, can also be considered. With it, the relationship between fault currents and nodal voltages can be defined. By this relationship, it can be emphasized that modeling of an ideal unbalanced short circuit with ZFI equal to zero, respectively, YFI going to infinity causes numerical problems if the structure of the equation is not changed. To overcome these problems, the unified fault matrix method offers also a solution. On this slide, the modeling of shunt faults using the unified fault matrix method is shown. In the first step, the three fault conditions at the faulted node are formulated. each shunt fault can have a fault impedance. In the table, on the right-hand side, the duality of the shunt and series faults concerning the fault conditions, respectively concerning the fault matrices, can be seen. For details, I refer also to the paper. In the second step, the fault conditions at all nodes are summarized in a shunt fault matrix FK, multiplying the grid equation system with the shunt fault matrix FK and adding of the fault conditions for the nodal voltages results in a grid equation system considering the shunt faults. This grid equation system has the same structure as a faultless grid equation system. The nodal admittance matrix can always, that means for all kinds of shunt faults, be inverted. This is possible since the fault conditions for the fault currents and the nodal voltages are incorporated in different rows of the nodal equation system. By this, the calculation of the inverse of YKK is always ensured. On this slide, a table is presented which shows the complete duality between shunt faults and series faults and its corresponding fault matrices. In particular, the duality between line-to-line short circuits and interruptions of equipment with isolated neutral and the corresponding fault matrices is shown on the right-hand side. On the next two slides, I will present two examples which shall show this duality. The first example deals with an ideal single pole interruption in conductor C of an equipment with an isolated neutral. And the second example deals with an ideal double pole line-to-line short circuit in conductors A and B. Both faults use the same fault matrix as it is highlighted in red in the table. The single pole interruption in conductor C of an equipment with an isolated neutral is shown in the figure on the left-hand side. Obviously, the current in conductor C is zero. Due to the isolated neutral, the currents in conductors A and B are opposite and equal. They can easily be calculated by using a mesh between the branches of conductor A and B. The currents depend on the two voltage sources of conductor A and B and the double positive sequence impedance. The result is given in the equation on the right-hand side. The same result can directly be derived by applying the unified fault matrix method. By applying the fault matrix for a single pole interruption in conductor C to the branch equation system, results in the equation at the bottom of the slide. The current IC is zero according to the fault condition. Setting of the neutral admittance to zero is easily possible. Furthermore, the three-phase structure is maintained. The second example deals with the ideal double pole line-to-line short circuit in conductors A and B in a network with one three-phase node. The network is shown in the figure on the left-hand side. Obviously, the fault current in conductor C is zero. Due to the line-to-line short circuit, the nodal voltages in conductors A and B are equal, and the fault currents are opposite and equal. The nodal voltages can easily be calculated by building the nodal equation at node A or node B, which are the same due to the short circuit. The nodal voltages depend on the two nodal current sources and the admittances. The result is given in the equation on the right-hand side. The same result can directly be calculated by using the unified fault matrix method. The application of the fault matrix for a double pole line-to-line short circuit in conductors A and B to the nodal grid equation system results in the equation at the bottom of the slide. Setting of the impedances to zero is easily possible. The three-phase structure is again maintained. To end my presentation, the following main points have to be concluded. The unified fault matrix method makes possible the calculation of arbitrary combinations of shunt and series faults in power systems. The order of the branch equations of the electrical equipment, as well as the order of the nodal equation system, are not changed. Fault impedances, respectively fault admittances, identical to zero, which represent the simulation of ideal short circuits or ideal interruptions, can be used without the emergence of numerical problems, as in conventional methods. A complete duality between shunt and series faults, and in particular, the duality between line-to-line short circuits and interruptions of electrical equipment with isolated neutral, are worked out. And the method can easily be applied to simulations of extended networks and to simulations in arbitrary coordinate systems, as well as to simulations in the time domain, for example, using the difference conductance method. I thank you all for listening and would be pleased to answer your questions.
Thank you for your presentation. So are there any questions? I do not see one in the Q&A. So maybe just one question from my side. What is the method currently used in programs for calculation of faults in the system? Is this something new to be implemented in this type of programs?
We use this model, this simulation method in our simulation tools for load flow as well as for short circuit calculations, as well for time domain simulations. And probably this method can also be used within other simulation programs. For example, I mentioned the difference conductance method, which is used, for example, in the ATP, EMTP. It can also be used, but this is a simulation in the time domain.
Okay.
But in principle, it can be used there also.
Okay, so thank you very much for your presentation and for answering my question.
Thank you very much.